Hey everyone, I am Kanahaiya Gupta and today I am gonna show you how to solve find digits HackerRank problem. In this problem we have given an integer. For each digit that makes up the integer, determine whether it's a divisor. We have to count the number of divisor occurring within the integer. Let's understand this with the help of an example. Here first we have given a T, which is number of test cases. So there are two test cases. First input is 12. So this is the number or integer, and we have to find out how many integers among this number completely divides this integer. First extract the individual integer from this number. So it will be 1 and 2. And just divide this number by 1, which is divisible, then divide with 2, it's divisible by 2 also. So now we have two numbers divide this completely, so the answer will be 2. Let's talk about this input. So in this input we have 4 integers individually, 1, 0, 1 and 2. So if we divide this number with 1, it's divisible. We have to make sure if there is any zero here, we are going to ignore it. Because if you divide some number by zero, either it will be infinity or it's undefined. So for that, what we are going to do, we are ignoring if any zero exists in between. So now we have 1, so divide with 1, so it is completely divisible. Then finally we have 2, if you divide this integer with 2, it's divisible. So we have 1, 2 and 3. So we have total 3 integers which divides this integer completely. So like that we have to build the logic to check how many digits are there which will divide the integer completely. Let's build the logic around it. Let's take one example here which contains zeros. So now we have this integer and we have to extract each and every digit from the integer and then divide this integer by digit one by one and see how many digits are completely divide this number. So the main task is to how we are going to extract the digits. So let me tell you one thing. There's a basic funda. If you want to extract digits from a number, you have to divide it via 10 first. Let me show you how it works. Suppose this is the number. So we'll divide the number via 10. So how we are going to write? We'll go one time. Then you will add 2 here. So now it's not divisible. You will add go 0 times. Now you will take 3. So now it will go 2 times. So 20. So now 3 is a remainder. It's not divisible. You will take 4. Now it will go 3 times, so it will be 30. Now remainder is 4. Now you can see we can't proceed. Did you notice that what is this? This remainder tells this is nothing, this is the last digit. And from this number, apart from the last digit, whatever was there, this quantity or apart from the last digit, this number is shown here. So what you have to do, you have to divide the number with 10. So whatever the remainder is there, that will give you the last digit. So now you got the last digit. You have extracted one digit from this number. But what about the next digit 3? How are you going to get this? So if you notice, to get this digit, you have to only take this digit and divide it with 10. So what are the remainder will be there? You will get 3. But how you will get this digit? So you can see this digit and this are same. It means next time in place of this complete integer, you have to use this quotient. And follow the same process. So what will happen next time? So if suppose if you take 1, 0, 2, 3, has a dividend and divide it with 10, so it will take 1 times,
So now you will do, so it's not divisible, so you will do go 0 times. Now you will take 3, so now it will go 2 times, so it's 20. Now remainder is 3. See, just notice, now this time 3 is the remainder, so the last digit, right? So now this time you got the last digit, and quotient is 102. So you have to keep on doing like this until you get each and individual digit. So now next time 102 will be your dividend, and then you have to follow the same process until dividend is 0. So like that, every time or every iteration you will get the last digit, so you are able to extract the digit. So this is what the idea we are going to use to extract the digit. Now we know how to extract the digit. Now I'll do the other process. So this is the logic we are going to use to get the digits. But this is the manual logic, how we used to do generally. But how we are going to tell the same thing to our program? Let's see how. We know in computer there are two symbols. This is for division and this is for modulo. So once you use this, you will get this quotient part. Or when you use this, you will get this remainder part. So if you have n equals to this, you have number n equals to 1, 0, 2, 3, 4. And if you want the quotient, you need to divide this with 10. Which will give you 1, 0, 2, 3, 4 divided 10. It will give you 1, 0, 2, 3. Which is this quotient. And if you want the remainder, in that case, you need to use this symbol, which is modulo symbol, with 10. So, 1, 0, 2, 3, 4, if you take the modulo with 10, you will get 4. So, these two operators you have to use to get quotient and remainder. And you have to make sure every time the quotient will change. This time we have divided n with this number, n is this, but next time whatever the quotient is there, that you have to divide with the 10. So next time this quotient will become a number n, and you will divide that with 10. So you will get 102 next time. So like that you have to do until it reaches to 0. So this is what the funda we are going to use. Now let's see how to write a program for this. So like I said, we are going to take a loop, which is a while loop, and we have to divide this integer until it's greater than 0. I showed you, right? So we have to divide this number until it becomes 0. And first, what I said, you have to take the remainder. So remainder will be n modulo 10. So by this, you will get the remainder. So which is the last digit, and you have to see whether this number is completely divisible with this digit or not. So for that, you can put a condition, and you can just see. But one thing you have to notice, guys, r should not be 0 remainder. As I said, if you find any 0 here, you have to ignore that. So you have to put one condition, r is not equals to 0, and this is completely divisible by last digit. It means, so the remainder should be 0. So if this is equals to 0, so in that case, we are going to increment the count, which will maintain the count, how many numbers are completely dividing this number. So if this condition is true, increment the count, then process further. So next time, extract the 3. You have to change this quantity and use the Q, quotient, from this. For getting the quotient, what you will do? N by 10. So now this time you need to divide N with 10. Previously you are taking the modulo to getting the remainder. But if you do like that, you will get the quotient, which is this. So next time N will be this. So that then N will come here. Next execution phase, you will get the remainder 3. So like this, we have to keep on doing until n is greater than 0. That's it. But one thing you have to make sure guys, once next time n is this, so this will not work. Why? Because now n is changed. N is 1, 0, 2, 3. But here what we were trying to do? We were trying to divide this complete number with that digit. But n is now changed. So what we will do? We will take one extra number and store this. Because we are modifying n internally. So we have to make sure what was the initial number. So instead of n, we will use number. So every time, we have to check whether the remainder is 0 or not. If it's not 0, then take the modulo of this number with remainder whatever you got and see whether it's 0 or not. If remainder is 0, it means it's completely divisible. And if it's completely divisible, then increase the count. This count will maintain the divisor count basically. Then again go to the next iteration and now next time n will be. So like that you have to keep on doing until all digit got processed or n is greater than 0. So this is what the logic guys which we are going to use. Let's see the algorithm in action guys. So I have a function called find digits and this is the integer which we are getting. So in that we have taken first count variable which will maintain the count, divisor count basically. Then we are storing n into a number. Why we are storing? Because we are modifying n inside our logic. So we should store this number before that. Because every time we have to check whether this number is divisible or not. So like I said, if we have to run our loop until n is greater than 0, and every time you are going to first take the remainder. For remainder, we will use the modulo operator here and we have to take the modulo with 10. So you'll get the remainder. And then you have to check remainder should not be 0. If it's 0, we are ignoring that. And that number, whatever the initial number was there, we have to just divide or take the modulo with that remainder and see whether it's 0 or not. If it's 0, it means that number is completely divisible with that digit. If it's completely divisible, then we are going to increment the count. Now this is the one step. For the next step, we are just modifying the n here. N equals to n by 10. So the next time, n will be having the number except the last digit. So you have to keep on doing this thing until n is greater than 0. So at the end, you will see in count, all the numbers which is dividing that integer will be there and you are going to return that count. Let's run this on a HackerRank platform. I am submitting this code directly because I know it will work. Congratulations guys. So you can see all test cases got passed. If you need the source code, you can go to my GitHub repository and the link is mentioned in the description box. Guys, I hope this problem is clear to you and if you have any better approach, please let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching guys.